All right, I want to be respectful of all your time, so I'm going to get started, and a few people may trickle in as we go. But first, I just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Robin Considine, and I am the Director of Secondary Education here at Sterling. So what that means is that I oversee the curriculum course offerings and the guidance department. So the purpose of the presentation tonight is just to familiarize you all with what Sterling has to offer so that when you begin planning your scheduling for ninth grade, you can do so with, you know, a lot of the resources and the information and make educated choices as you begin your time here at Sterling High School. I do want to begin by simply letting you all know that everything, this PowerPoint, as well as the recording of tonight, will be on our school website. So I'm going to go through some information about testing and course requirements and, you know, scheduling. You don't have to take out cameras and take pictures or jot down anything. It will all be available on the website by the end of the week. So I do want to make sure that you guys are all aware of that. What I'm going to go over tonight are some curriculum initiatives, so some of the things that we have been working on over the last few years, as well as exploring the program planning guide. So the program planning guide is the listing of all of the courses with descriptions that we offer here at Sterling. And then in doing so, by exposing you to these pieces of information to help prepare you for scheduling. So a few of the curriculum initiatives. First of all, our curriculum is aligned to the New Jersey Student Learning Standards. So these standards evolve. They, you know, they change from year to year. Sometimes there's a cycle of like 3 years worth of changes. We're always reviewing the updates to the standards. We're aligning our curriculum to these standards, as well as looking for trends nationally so that we can prepare our students for college and career. Additionally, we firmly believe in using data-driven instruction and decisions in our planning. You will see that probably in January, I'm going to be requesting that our sending schools administer a Linkit benchmark to our eighth grade students. This Linkit benchmark will provide us with consistent data amongst our three sending schools so that we can use this to accurately place students in courses that will, you know, where they'll be successful, but we'll also challenge them. We will then continue to use Linkit here at Sterling as an online assessment platform, as well as a data warehouse. And in doing so, it will assist our teachers and as well as administration in assessing our students and using the data to drive what the teachers are doing in the classroom, as well as some curricular changes that we may need to make, especially this year. We were using this information, obviously coming out of COVID, you know, there was some learning loss amongst our students, so we wanted to use this information in order to provide supports for our students when needed. We also have many opportunities for remediation and extension, so whether it was in the morning, in the afternoon, or during the school day, we provide opportunities for students to meet with staff, to meet with students. If they need assistance, we have NHS, our National Honor Society. We have students that will tutor one another. So there's peer tutoring during the day. We have staff tutoring after school. And then we also offer programs both during the day and after school that allow students to, you know, pursue interests of theirs and extend the learning that is taking place in the classroom. One-to-one initiative. This sounds like, you know, most schools now, especially following COVID, have implemented a one-to-one initiative. We were proud to say that, you know, going into remote learning, our students and staff were already very familiar with how to use the technology platform. We use Microsoft. So the transition, though very different, was as seamless as it could be. So we use technology, teachers use technology to deliver lessons. Students use technology to collaborate with one another. Students and teachers can communicate. So we really use the Microsoft platform as a major initiative in our instruction in the classroom. And then another curriculum initiative is bringing creativity and innovation to the classroom. So as important as it is to deliver content to students, it's also important for students to be able to think, to work through problems, to be creative, and to you know, be innovative in activities. So we stress to our teachers to provide opportunities for students to not only be able to work, not only be able to share content with the teachers, but also be able to create and to, you know, be creative in their thinking and in their producing. Sterling operates under a 4x4 block schedule. So this is a little different than, you know, maybe a high school that you're familiar with, an 8-period day, or now there's a lot of creative schedules with rotating blocks and so forth. But we operate under a 4x4 block schedule. So we have 2 semesters. So we're actually about halfway through our first semester right now. And we have 2 semesters, one from the beginning of the school year till the end of January, and then the other from the end of January through the end of the school year. And each semester is broken into 4 academic blocks, and then what we call the middle of the day block 3A and 3B. There's lunch during one of those blocks, and then an opportunity either for a study hall or an additional credit-bearing opportunity, a credit-bearing course that a student can take. So what would a sample 9th grade schedule look like? So I just plugged in some of the requirements that our 9th graders would have to take, which is a math course, a health and PE, a world language, a science course, history and English, and then 2 specific electives that we require our 9th graders to take are English composition and digital applications. Again, the digital applications goes hand in hand with the one-to-one initiative, so students understand, number one, how to use technology appropriately, and then some of our expectations at Sterling for the use of technology. And English composition is a course that provides students with some of the foundational English skills that we want our students to have, in addition to the contents and the standards that are in our English course. Within a freshman schedule, there is also an opportunity usually for 2 additional electives. So if you see here, right down here, this student has PE wellness and TV production. Okay. One thing that I do want to stress is that the process of scheduling, we start with our seniors, then our juniors, then our sophomores, then our freshmen. Freshmen don't often have a lot of choice in the electives that they have during their freshman year. But no, as they go through their 4 years here, the opportunities for them grow. So they have more opportunity, you know, to select different electives that may interest them. With that being said, we also, using that data that I had talked about, sometimes we will put freshmen into a pre-algebra class, which is another quarter class. So these here are quarter classes. And that would be one less elective that freshman gets to take. Additionally, I said there are 4 blocks, kind of 4 academic blocks, and then the middle of the day. So right here where you see chorus and lunch, that's the middle of the day. So this student chose, in lieu of a study hall in the middle of the day, to take chorus. And as I said, we do offer some credit-bearing courses in the middle of the day, chorus, band, law and public safety, African American studies. We do offer courses in the middle of the day that students that are interested in have that opportunity to take. Majority of our students take advantage of the study hall in the middle of the day. The program planning guide. So I had talked about in planning for scheduling, you're going to want to familiarize yourself with the program planning guide. And I'm going to highlight some parts of the program planning guide this evening. But the first thing I wanted to do is make sure you guys are aware of where you can find the program planning guide. So if you were to go to the Sterling website and go under parents, there is a curriculum tab, and within the curriculum tab is the program planning guide. So please, I will highlight some of the important aspects of this. This PowerPoint is going to be shared with you, but please also take a look at this program planning guide before you start your scheduling meetings, which are a few months away, so you have plenty of time to review this, so that you see the course offerings that you have. Again, selections are somewhat limited for our 9th grade students. However, we want to make sure that you are aware of what opportunities we have here at Sterling. Within that program planning guide, one thing that's important for you to review are the graduation requirements. So So really, graduation is tied to two things. One is credits. You have to maintain a certain number of credits, or obtain, I should say, a certain number of credits by the end of your senior year. And there has to be credits within certain areas, and I'll go over that in a minute. And then there's also a testing requirement. Okay. So the state of New Jersey requires that students have a specific number of credits in different areas. So within English, you have to have 20 credits, mathematics, 15 credits, health and PE, 20 credits, so forth and so on. Our classes, a semester class is 5 credits. A quarter class is half of that. It's 2.5 credits. We do have some year-long classes, okay, and they would be 10 credits each. So the credits are based on the number of hours or the seat time that you're in that class. So these are the minimum credits that you need in each of these different content areas in order to meet the New Jersey Department of Ed requirements based on credits. And then over here, additional information are just the classes that we have in order to meet those credit requirements. In addition to the credits, there is also an assessment requirement. And this has changed, I think, probably 5 times in the last 10 years. Okay, but as of now, the testing requirements for the class of 2023, so our current juniors and beyond, so those of you that are here this evening, is a new assessment called the Graduation Proficiency Assessment. And it's comprehensive, and it's based on standards up through English 10 and Algebra 1 and Geometry. So by 11th grade, if a student progresses on track, they would definitely have English 10 completed and up through Geometry completed. Okay, so this is a comprehensive test up through those standards. I wish I could give you more information about this test at this time, but it's brand new, so I haven't had any experience. And honestly, there's very limited information that has been given to us at this point, but just know that I will send home information as the tests become closer and we know a little bit more information for it. If a student is not successful on this test, there are alternatives. So what the state of New Jersey has is they created a menu of options. So if a student, the first pathway to graduate would be to pass this test. And then beyond that, there's cut scores for the SATs, the PSATs. There's a test called the ASVAB, ACCUPLACER. So there are other options for students if they are not successful on this test. But that is the first option. The reason I tell you that is because you're going to start taking, we offer the PSATs we start them in 9th grade, but for the purposes of this graduation requirement, it's the 10th grade offering of the PSATs. Starting in 10th grade, you could already meet your testing requirement, okay, should you not be successful. So it seems crazy to be talking about graduation right now, and you guys are not even, graduates of 8th grade yet. But what we always say is when you step foot in Sterling, or actually even when you sit down with your counselor and do your scheduling, you're starting to build your high school resume, and it all accumulates with graduation. Okay, so you want to keep that in mind. I'll take any questions at the end, okay? Additionally, though this is not a testing requirement, there is another assessment that the state of New Jersey requires our students to take through 9th grade. So it's from 3rd grade through 9th grade, and it's the NJSLA, New Jersey Student Learning Assessment. So 9th grade students will take that test. So at Sterling, state test, you'll take a test in 9th grade, and then you'll take a test in 11th grade. The 11th grade one is the one that is the graduation requirement. The important information from this test, especially getting students from 3 sending schools and choice students, is to really give us some valuable data and some baseline data to help us plan effective instruction for our students. Sterling really prides itself on offering our students many opportunities in special programs as well as dual credit and advanced placement. When I send out this PowerPoint, there will be links here. But just to highlight, this is the number of classes that we offer that are dual credit and or AP. So where students have the opportunity to walk away with college credits. Okay, what's better than walking out of high school, with 15 credits under your belt and starting college maybe halfway through your freshman year? I know parents will like that because college is expensive. So, you know, if you can get some of those high school, if some of those college credits under your belt before you even graduate from high school, what a great opportunity. We have partnered with Camden County College, Stockton University, and Rowan University in order, and Rutgers University in order to offer some of these programs. So if students successfully complete the programs here, again, they have the opportunity to walk away with college credit. Additionally, we have some special programs. So we have programs in television production, ROTC, performing arts, health science. These programs also are often, not always, but are often tied to those dual credit courses. So for instance, you may have seen, you know, one of the dual credit courses, anatomy and physiology or medical terminology. There are programs within our Allied Health Science program. If you were to take those courses in a sequential order, you would have potential to leave here with four college courses under your belt through Rutgers University. Keep in mind, those courses are very, very often transferable to other four-year colleges. Same thing with Camden County, same thing with the course that we have through Stockton. Okay. I am going to show you, this is going to be a quick video that highlights some of these special programs.
Allied Health is a cooperative program with Rutgers University School of Health Professions. Any student who is interested in a diverse field of health science careers, including nursing, surgery, physical therapy, pharmacy, or laboratory research, will benefit from this hands-on program that emphasizes crafting the ability to think critically and solve problems through experimentation, dissection, and field experience. Students who enroll in Allied Health have the opportunity to take five classes worth up to 17 college credits, including anatomy, physiology 1 and 2, medical math, medical terminology, and dynamics of healthcare. Credits are transferable and accepted by many colleges and universities outside of Rutgers. Volunteerism is also a part of Allied Health, where students will participate in local food and blood drives, among other initiatives. And students who pursue this route often find themselves as candidates for the National Honor Society. There are many more opportunities offered through Allied Health, and we proudly acknowledge that the majority of students who participate leave with most of the credits and go on to four-year institutions where they demonstrate success in the fields of study they choose. Regardless of the path your child may choose, our objective is to prepare students for the rigors of college, career, and life. I'm sure that you've heard of the concept of STEM or STEAM, but what is all the hype about? STEM careers are some of the most in-demand, highest-paying jobs out there. Unlike other classes where learning happens independent of each other, STEM classes allow students to connect disciplines. Students work together in collaborative groups to apply knowledge from the sciences to solve engineering problems. Many of the students from our STEM program have gone on to major in engineering and computer science in college. If you have an interest in science, engineering, or technology, enroll in STEM class. Believe the hype. The Sterling Performing Arts Department features two curricular performing ensembles and four extracurricular ensembles. The concert band and concert choir are the cornerstones of the program and feature the most students all together. These groups perform our winter and spring concerts, as well as several community functions and field trips throughout the year. There are over 100 students involved in our concert ensembles, so they serve as a great way for new students to make friends and be immersed in the Sterling community right away. In addition to the concert band, there are two extracurricular instrumental ensembles, the marching band and jazz band. The marching band is a performance ensemble open to all students in grade 9 through 12. It combines music, dance, and military-esque marching into one activity and is composed of several different sections, including drummers, percussionists, horn players, and color guard, who dance and spin flags and rifles. The marching band season runs from mid-July to early November, performing at local parades, football games, and marching band competitions. The Jazz Band is an audition performing ensemble that runs from January through April. Students learn about and perform classic and contemporary jazz repertoire while developing fundamental skills in improvisation. The Jazz Band also performs all over the tri-state area in jazz competitions. In the vocal music department, there are also two extracurricular ensembles. The Silvertones are an audition-only show choir that performs at competitions and community events. The second group is the cast of the Spring Musical. They put on a theatrical show that brings thousands of community members out to see it every year. Both groups are great for students who are more passionate about performing on stage. Our course offerings in the music department are also very extensive. Our most popular class is piano, where students of any skill level can learn to play. Our other classes include music technology, where the students learn to use software associated with sound engineering, music appreciation, where students can learn about history and styles of music, music theory, where students study the language of music through analysis of composition, music workshop, where students can learn a new instrument or focus on technical practice or repertoire of their own on a current instrument in a similar setting than concert band. The musical theater, a class for students more interested in learning more singing and acting technique. The Early Childhood Education Program is a five-course program that incorporates a preschool laboratory component in the upper levels. Child development is a theory-based course that will help students gain an understanding of physical, cognitive, and social and emotional development milestones from conception until the age of 8. Early Childhood 1 through 4 all take place in conjunction with the preschool program. Students in all four of these courses complete weekly lesson plans and post-teaching reflections, as well as observations that pertain to the specific course content. Early Childhood 1 focuses on the planning, preparation, and delivery of developmentally appropriate curriculum for young children, including the history of early childhood education and various curriculum models. Early Childhood 2 explores childhood health, safety, and nutrition needs. Early Childhood 3 takes a more in-depth look at the curriculum design and the integration of developmentally appropriate creative experiences in the early childhood learning classroom. Early Childhood 4 will guide the students in creating a portfolio that they can use to help earn their Child Development Associate, a national credential that is a stepping stone to a career in early childhood education. The program is articulated through Camden County College, and the students who choose to complete all five classes will have the opportunity to earn 12 college credits. Students are also encouraged to join FCCLA, a national association that promotes career development in family and consumer sciences, such as early childhood, culinary arts, fashion design, and more. Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps is the only formalized leadership development program taught at the high school level. The two instructors teaching junior ROTC serve full careers in the U.S. Navy and have over 50 years of combined leadership experience. The difference between our leadership program and other high school opportunities is that we teach leadership fundamentals and principles in the classroom and then supervise the students in a practical application environment. Our company quarters class serves as an annual gym class requirement and provides the lab environment to practice leadership skills during physical activity, close order drill, and uniform inspections. The cadets get their chance to lead their peers in numerous extracurricular activities we offer. We have competitive drill teams, a marksmanship air rifle program, and academic, physical fitness, and orienteering competitions. We also average over 60 hours of community service per cadet per year. It's a complete mind, body, and spirit approach to leadership development. While this program is modeled on the Navy Corps values of honor, courage, and commitment, there is no requirement to serve in the military. While some of our cadets join the military after high school through a variety of service academy appointments, college ROTC scholarship programs, and direct service enlistments, our primary focus is to help the students achieve whatever their goals are after high school. Whether it be college or trade school or military service, all of our graduates have a plan. We take numerous field trips, invite numerous visitors in to talk about careers, and to guide our cadets to success. Your student will gain respect, self-discipline, and leadership while having fun and making lifelong friends at Sterling and other schools across the region. Our mission is to take good high school students and make them great. I hope your student joins our family and gets to grow with us over the next 4 years. In our own TV and radio studios, students will learn to design, direct, produce, and edit television and radio broadcasts. Students develop their public speaking, journalism, management, and technical skills by appearing on the Sterling Morning News on Channel 19 and on our radio station, WSHS. Unique to Sterling High School is our Channel 19, which is a TV channel that goes out to Summerdale, Stratford, Magnolia, Laurel Springs, and Hinella on Comcast Channel 19, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, with student-produced programming of sports, shows, and community events. The radio station features music DJed by students and live sporting events. Inside the TV classroom, our students produce award-winning TV public service announcements, make music videos, and develop and produce their own TV shows. In the radio classes, the students learn to convey important announcements and entertain fellow students as well as our community. If communications is your possible area of study, Sterling High School offers opportunities not available in most high schools across South Jersey. Whether it's allied health, STEM, performing arts, early childhood education, NJROTC, or TV and radio, Sterling High School has something for everyone. Go Knights!
So as you can see, we offer a lot of programs here that I think are unique to Sterling, and I think are in addition to what a lot of local high schools offer. We're proud to say that we're a comprehensive high school, so if you want to come and you want to kind of explore everything, we have opportunities to do that. But if you know something that you're already interested in, we have even more opportunities for you, because you can begin that within your freshman year, and you can learn skills that are going to be transferable to work and beyond. So we're really proud of these programs that we have to offer, and we're always looking at, you know, what our staff has as well as what our students want, and we try to mesh those two together so that we can provide as many opportunities for our students to pursue whatever they want after high school, whether it's college, whether it's career, in one of these fields or somewhere else. In addition to these classes that you heard or these programs, if you may be interested in something but you're not sure, you don't have to like commit to a program. You can simply say, I want to try one of these health science classes. I think I might be interested in nursing. And you could just take a class individually. And then if you like it, then maybe you would work with your counselor, you would work with the teachers to try to find a path that's best for you. So we offer a lot of programs, but we also, we serve as a comprehensive high school that will, serve the needs of our students and our community. Speaking of the counselors that you would talk to if you had an interest, our counseling department is broken up by the first initial of the student's last name, and we do have 5 counselors in our counseling department, and they are your counselor for all 4 years, okay? Tonight, I have 2 counselors with me. So first, I have Ms. Cooker. So Ms. Cooker, if you could say, Ms. Cooker has students with the last names A through C. We have Mr. Kontrovich, who is not here this evening. He has students with the last names D through J. With us, we also have Mr. Bill Scully. He would be the counselors of students whose last name is K through N. Mrs. Patrice Lytle and Mrs. Eberly are not here, and they have the end of the alphabet. If you are interested in reaching out to the counselor ahead of time, if you have questions, you can always feel free to do so. Their information is on the website as well. Again, this PowerPoint, there are live links, so they would take you right to their emails. In response to COVID, we thought it was really important to kind of take a look at the needs of our students as they're coming back to school. And in doing so, we wanted to focus on not only the, as I talked about, using data for learning loss and things of that nature, but we really needed to focus on social-emotional learning for our students. In order for them to be successful in the classroom, they have to be in a good place mentally. In doing so, we used qualitative and quantitative data to get together with our admin and our staff and our guidance department, and we looked at ways that we can support our students. We've created a mental health committee. The mental health committee meets bi-monthly to kind of survey where we are as a school and what needs what our needs are and what needs to be addressed. We also have the social-emotional learning curriculum that we're working on with our teachers in order to, again, support the students, the whole student, not just, again, the academics. In doing so, we've also created some wellness activities that have been really successful. We just started it about a month ago. Again, taking interest of students, taking the talents of our staff, and working together to see where our students would benefit from activities after school where they can work on something they're interested in, have a staff member they can talk to, work with their peers, collaborate. And as of now, we have activities in culinary arts. Culinary arts is probably our number one elective. Students all want to take it. It's often challenging to get on the schedule because it's everyone's number one choice. A lot of students really like it. So now students have an opportunity. If it's something they're really interested in and they couldn't get it on their schedule, they can pursue this passion of theirs after school. We also have meditation, reading self-discovery, gratitude journaling. So again, we're looking for opportunities to support needs of our students based on some of the talents of our staff. So talking about scheduling, we gave you a lot of information, a lot of resources where you can find more information. And it may seem early, as I said, we're about a quarter of the way through eighth grade right now. And these dates seem far away, but they'll come quickly, and the information that we need to prepare for these is even quicker. So the scheduling appointments aren't until mid-April, but we're going to start collecting information from the sending schools in January. So, we all know how quick these first few months of school are, and we know how quick November goes and December goes. So starting in January, we're going to start collecting information so that we can prepare on our end for placement of your students in classes, as I said in the beginning, where they'll be successful, but we'll also challenge them. So we're looking at mid-April for our scheduling appointments. We come down during the school day. They take place at the school district. So we'll go to Yellum, we'll go to Magnolia, we'll go to Somerdale. And our counselors will meet with students, and it really serves as twofold. One, it puts a face to a name. So transitioning from middle school to high school is a lot. There's a lot of choices that you have to make, and the transition alone. Some students, depending what school you're coming from, you may have been in the same building for the last 8 years. So this is definitely a transition. Having a face to a name, knowing someone that you can go to on day one if you have a question, it really eases a lot of anxiety that students have in transitioning. So that's the first thing. Let's just put a face to a name, someone that the students can know on that first day of school. And also, let's talk about the courses. Let's talk about what interests you have. Again, selections are limited for freshmen, and I know I keep saying this, but if you're really interested in one of those programs that were highlighted in that video, make sure you tell your counselor. There's opportunities in freshman year to get a jump start in some of those programs. So make sure you communicate that with your counselor. Though the appointments are during the school day, parents are welcome to attend. They're pretty brief. They're about 10 to 15 minutes, I think, usually in length. So, I would feel bad if you had to take a whole day off work. But if you could scoot out for a few minutes and go to the conference, I do think that, it would be beneficial for you. And also, if this is your first child going through high school, it may, it's going to be informational for you to attend those scheduling appointments. And it says there it's a meet and greet. It's looking at academic courses and graduation requirements. We talked about elective requests. We're also going to review contact information. It's so important for us to have accurate information as we move into the summer so that we can be sure to communicate everything with families. So course listing. So once you meet with your counselor and you create your course wish list and we review, data and testing and what classes you're going to have the next year, students will receive their course listings by June 3rd, and they will have until June 15th to request any changes. So if when you sat down at the meeting, you were like, yeah, I want to take Spanish, and then you decide, you get your course listing, I really kind of had a change of heart, I think I want to take French, okay? You have, close to a two-week turnaround to let your counselor know. That is a firm deadline, that June 15th. Our counselors are not here in the summer, it's challenging to make schedule changes. So we do have a policy, June 15th, schedule changes will need to be made. So I'm going to, make sure I say that now, and we'll communicate that throughout the year once we, at the scheduling meeting, once course listings are given out. New student orientation. So this is important for our incoming ninth graders to attend. We kind of usually have groups that go rotate around. We have athletics and activities, so students can see if there's something that they're interested in. We have tables set up with different sports that we offer, different activities that we offer, so students can kind of learn what Sterling has to offer outside of the academics. We take freshman pictures during that time, and then we usually just have an informational session for students and their parents. And that date is yet to be determined, but again, we'll make sure we communicate that with you, and we're looking at a June date for the new student orientation. And then I had talked about that one-to-one initiative and how you get your tablet and you keep it for all 4 years, and we will be doing that in the summer as well, so we will communicate that with families. Okay, just a quick timeline. All right, so I want to open it up to questions. So if there's any questions that are good for the whole group, I'll take them now. And then at the end, if there's any individual questions, I'll be here. Ms. Cooker, Mr. Scully will be here if anyone has any individual questions. So any questions for the group? You think you need the mic or are you good, Leo? Okay. AccuPlace. You're good? Okay, that's a good question. So the question, if you didn't hear, is, you know, we talked about the graduation testing requirement as well as the alternate graduation testing requirements. So the 11th grade test is mandatory for students to take. So it's the others are like a fail-safe. So should you not pass that, then it's kind of like a net that you're falling into. We can meet it this using one of these other assessments. But yes, that 11th grade test is a required test that students will have to take. So good question. Any other questions for the group? Okay, so I know it's mid-November. We have a lot of months leading up to the scheduling meeting. If at any time you have any questions, whether you're looking at the program planning guide or you're talking to, you know, your teachers in your school right now, and any questions come up, please feel free to email us. We're getting the information out earlier this year than we usually do. We usually do it a little bit closer to the scheduling timeline, but we thought it was important for you guys to all be aware of what we have to offer, you know, so that you can think it all over, digest it, and plan, the best, or I should say, create the best resume for your students starting now. So again, we'll be here if you guys have any questions. I thank you for coming out tonight. Have a great evening.